name is Amy Gleason, and I am the instructor for Sydney High School's television production class. For those of you wondering what exactly this class entails, let me show you. Welcome to our studio. In this class, students choose various projects. They videotape those projects with a camera. They download their video into one of our editors. We have two Casablanca editors, and they also use various computer programs like Movie Maker and Pinnacle Studio. Why don't you sit back and enjoy watching some of the projects that we've done over the last year and a half.
Good morning, SHS.
My name is Kim Varhorst.
And I'm Trisha Ashman,
reporting for SBC.
Our first candidate for homecoming queen is involved with student government, National Honor Society, varsity cheerleading, mixed choir, women's choir, solo ensemble, and post-secondary options. She is currently employed as a kinetics instructor at the YMCA. Her future plans are to attend Wright State or Ohio State University and major in integrated language arts, English education. This very active student is Miss Katie Bowler.
I am very excited about going to homecoming because I'll get to hang out with all my friends and I like to dance.
Yes, I'm very excited about homecoming.
I'm really excited. Homecoming's gonna be a blast.
Another City graduate being inducted into the Hall of Honor is Sheila Sly, who graduated in 1983. Her teachers remember her fondly, especially Mr. Donald Steffen, who taught English here and who nominated her for this honor. Studying broadcast journalism at The Ohio University, Ms. Sly graduated magna cum laude in only 3 years. Following college, she held various radio and television news positions in West Virginia, where she changed her name from Sheila Sly to Sheila Gray. According to one program director in Charleston, nobody would trust a news reporter with the name of Sly. After working as an 11 p.m. co-anchor in Charleston, Sheila became the youngest woman to anchor the 6 p.m. news at WSAZ-TV. Currently, she is increasing ratings for Fox 19's early morning news.
Interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin. The Japanese have attacked Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, by air. President Roosevelt has just announced.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. No matter how long it may take us to overcome this premeditated invasion, the American people in their righteous might will win through to absolute victory.
On December 7, 1941, Japan bombed Pearl Harbor, which provoked the mobilization of the United States Armed Forces. For years, the world had been at war, beginning with Adolf Hitler's ascension to power and the German invasion of Poland. As the war progressed, the U.S. maintained its neutrality despite supplying Great Britain with war materials. However, with the assault on Pearl Harbor, the United States was forced onto the offensive. 300,000 casualties later, the United States dropped the atomic bomb on Hiroshima. The war had a major influence on daily life in Shelby County. 1,400 men joined the armed forces from Shelby County. Conversely, the workforce jumped by then more than 2,500 workers. Local industry, such as Copeland, Monarch, Stolle, Sydney Tool, and Ross Aluminum boomed during this period as production shifted to fuel the war effort. One such local hero was Chief William Kingseed of Sydney, Ohio. Mr. Kingseed served in the Navy on the USS McDonough during the war and served in the Pacific Theater. He was first stationed in Hawaii and has fond memories of the beautiful setting.
We got out there in 1939, and it's a beautiful place. Loved it. Just wonderful, everything about it. I took a tour of the island. I remember that soon after we got there. And I was quite impressed with everything. I mean, just everything there. There wasn't that much Navy there at the time. And I don't know, they just were so good to you wherever you went. If you got one beer, it was on the house, you know, and everything. Just great. Of course, Pearl Harbor, that was a quite exciting Sunday morning. I just finished cooking breakfast at the time. And I was standing out on deck with the chief gunner's mate having a cup of coffee when we saw the planes coming in over the mountain. And we stood there and watched them. Well, we figured probably the Army out there. Couldn't figure why they were out on a Sunday. And then we noticed the markings on them. Figured Japanese planes, and they come in diving down, and I think it was the old Utah, an old obsolete battleship we had. They hit that one first, and they bombed it, torpedoed it, and so tip over, fellas in the water trying to swim ashore, and they were diving at them, shooting at them. Then the Raleigh was an old cruiser. They sunk that out there.
I hope you enjoyed viewing some of our projects that we've accomplished in this class over the last year and a half. We look forward to a new and exciting year in television production class. Thank you.